Let's take a look at solving word problems in scientific notation. The problem example reads, in 1990, there were approximately 76 million people in the United States. 9 years later, in 1999, there were approximately 272 million people. Part A wants us to use scientific notation to find out how much larger is the population in 1999 than in 1990. Find out exactly what it is we need to do to start solving this problem. So we're going to look at how much larger the population is. So the first thing we're going to do is convert our standard notation, our standard form, into scientific notation. So 1990, 7.61 times 10 to the 7th power. 1999, 2.727 times 10 to the 8th power. So looking at this problem, we're going to decide what is our first step? So we are going to look at 1999 population, subtract 1990 population. So we're going to subtract the larger population from the smaller population. So let's set that up. Now when we subtracting, okay, let's see if you guys remember that rule. When we subtracting in scientific notation, we need to make our exponents the same. You always want to make your exponent bigger. So I'm going to move my decimal one place over to the left so I can make my exponent the same, which would leave me with my final answer. When I subtract my two coefficients, when I subtract the first factors, it would leave me with 1.966 times 10 to the 8th power. Hope that makes sense. Let's look at part B. Part B says the population in Canada in 1999 was 3.04 times 10 to the 7th power. What is the total population of the United States and Canada in 1999? So what is our first step that we're going to look at? We need to find out what it is we need to do in order to solve this problem. So it asks for the total population of the United States and Canada. So what are we going to do? Let's set it up. So I'm going to have the US population plus Canada population. So I have 2.727 times 10 to the 8th power plus 3.04 times 10 to the 7th power. Once again, when we're adding and subtracting in scientific notation, we need to make our powers the same. So I am going to make my power bigger by moving my decimal one place over with my smallest power. When I move that one place over, now my powers are the same, leaving me with 3.031 times 10 to the 8th power. Hope that's making sense to you right now. Okay, let's take a look at another word problem example. The volume of Venus is approximately 9.4 times 10 to the 11th power. The volume of Mars is approximately 1.6 times 10 to the 11th power. Part A says, about how many times as great as the volume of Mars is the volume of Venus? So the first thing we need to know is what operation is in question. So we're going to look for some keywords or a keyword to help us determine what operation we are going to use. So we can look at about how many times. So let's go ahead and set that up. So I'm going to have 9.4 times 10 to the 11th power divide 1.6 times 10 to the 11th power. Now let's go ahead and pull that apart and put our first factors together and our powers together. So I have 9.4 divide 1.6 times 10 to the 11th power divide 10 to the 11th power. Now, remember the rule. When we have the same base and we're dividing, what do you do with your exponents? Hope you said subtract because you are correct. Good job. Now, let's go ahead and perform that operation, which will leave us with 5.876 times 10 to the 0 power. So that will tell us that the volume of Venus is approximately 5.9 times as great as the volume of Mars. Hope that makes sense. Let's look at part B. The volume of Earth is approximately 0.69 times 10 to the negative 1 power times larger than the volume of Mars. What is the approximate volume of Earth? So now let's see how we are going to set this problem up. What's in question? Times larger. So what are they asking us to do? What operation is in question? If you say multiplication, you're correct. All right, so let's go ahead and set it up. So I have volume of Earth equal volume of Mars times 0.69 times 10 to the negative 1 power. Now, I'm looking at my numbers. One of my numbers is not written in proper scientific notation. So remember, Before we can do any operation, you must put your numbers in proper scientific notation. So let's go ahead and put that number in proper scientific notation. So I am moving from a small number to a big number. So that means I have to subtract a power. So when we subtract that power, it's going to leave me with 10 to the negative 2 power. So now let's break it apart, put my first factors together, 1.6 times 6.9, and my powers together, 10 to the 11th power times 10 to the negative 2nd power. Go ahead and do the math for my coefficients and operation for my powers. So that leaves me with 11.04 times 10 to the 9th power. And we finish. Hope you said no, because remember, you always want to ask yourself, self, is my number written in proper scientific notation? If not, let's go ahead and put it in proper scientific notation. So 11 is greater than 10. So I'm moving from a big number to a small number. So I am going to add a power. So when I add a power, that's going to leave me with 1.104 times 10 to the 10th power. Hope that makes sense to you. Don't worry, we'll get to do tons of practice in class. Remember, you can always pause, rewind, and watch as many times as you like.